Hello, class 11th. This video is for you. Now I am starting third lesson. I have given you, it means now till now we have done from the hornbill. First is the portrait of lady, then photograph, poem. Next chapter also we have done, we are not afraid to die. This is the third chapter, discovering truth. The saga continues by A.R. Williams. Okay. Children, this is historical chapter. Okay. It is from the beginning, before, it means chapter starts from the next, it means from the next paragraph, but it is given about the king, King Tut. He was a teenager when he died, the last heir of the powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was laid to rest laden with gold and eventually forgotten. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated about what happened to him, with murder being the most extreme possibility. Like here, it is about he is used for King Tut. It is given over there. When he died, he was a teenager. Okay. He was 19 years of age when he died. And he was the last heir, means the successor of the powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. Now you can just make it out like here, one century is of 100 years. Now here it is used the word centuries. He was laid to rest laden with gold. It means when he died, in his coffins, that is laden. Laden means full of gold and eventually forgotten. It means a lot of gold was put in his coffin along with him. And then later on, that is everybody forgot about him. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, it was done by Howard Carter. An archaeologist. The modern world has speculated, guessed about what happened to him. They were just making a guess what must have happened, what might have happened, because he was only 19 year old. Then how a child could die, or a teenager would die like this in such an age, happening nothing. It means everybody was thinking that he must have been killed. Like here, what happened to him, with murder being the most extreme possibility. Now, leaving his tomb for the first time in almost 80 years, the year when he was taken out, it means the first time in almost 80 years, Tut has undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death. Okay, then it means that is his mummy was taken out. And then that a CT scan was done, new clues, that is where it means the science scientific technology told about what could be the possibility. Now here, and provides precise data for an accurate forensic reconstruction of the boy's Paro. And then that is now that is precise means accurate data were collected. And forensic reconstruction, it means report was made just to make the possibility what could have been, how he must have died. Now in this chapter, we are reading about this only. Okay, now the next. An angry wind stirred up ghostly dust devils as King Tut was taken from his resting place in the ancient Egyptian cemetery known as the Valley of Kings. Like here, when his coffin was taken out from the Valley of Kings, where he was buried at that time, then all of a sudden the stormy wind started. Ghostly, that is here it is wind stirred up. Wind stirred up, it means that it started blowing. Now then, ghostly dust devils as King Tut was taken. It means dust, like in the Egypt, there is a lot of dust there. So clouds of dust were there outside in the atmosphere. Now they feel over there that he was disturbed from his resting place, when cemetery, graveyard, and that is known as the Valley of Kings. Dark-bellied clouds had scudded across the desert sky all day and now were veiling the stars in the cascade gray. Children, this chapter is a bit difficult. Now you pay attention here. Dark-bellied clouds, it means the dark clouds, round dark clouds over there. Scudded means across the desert. It means they were moving from one side to the other side in the sky, the whole day they kept on moving from one side to the other side. Now were veiling. Veiling means covering the stars in the cascade gray. Cascade gray means in the sky, and they also covered the stars in the sky. It was 6 p.m. on January 5, 2005. It means when it was taken out. It was, that is, in the evening, and it was 5 January, that is, and 2005. The world's most famous mummy glided head first into a CT scanner brought here to probe the lingering medical mysteries of this little understood young ruler who died more than 3,300 years ago. And it means his mummy was taken out, glided means smoothly was put into the CT scanner. Then to probe means to look into the matter. Lingering means hanging, that was pending still. Medical mysteries, those were like pending. So the more with the help of the modern technology, they wanted to know over there what happened to this young ruler who died more than 3,300 years before. All afternoon, the usual line of tourists from around the world had descended into the crammed rocker tomb from some 26 feet underground to pay their respect. Like here, children, first let me just tell you the meaning of difficult word along with this one over there. That is crammed. Crammed means, that is, it means very small room was there. Crammed one, it means the shrunken one, we can just say over there. Now here, descended means got down. That is there. First, what is this? When they took him out from the Valley of Kings, then in a rock cut tomb, it means some 26 feet underground. It means on the, that is, a hill or the rock was cut, one room was made, and first, that is, the coffins were kept there only. And then they were allowed, public was allowed to pay the homage to such a great king. They gazed at the murals on the walls of the burial chamber and peered at Tut's gilded face. They means people, public over there. Gazed means they were just gazing, they were just staring, they were watching carefully what the murals. Murals means pictures on the walls of the burial chamber, where the burial chamber was there. It means that is called burial chamber. That was, rock was cut and a chamber was made, and that was called burial chamber. Okay, and those people were looking on the murals, means on the pictures, those which were hung on the walls of that burial chamber. And they were also looking at Tut's gilded face. Gilded face means decorated face. Decorated means because there was so much gold, even in the pictures also it was shown there. The most striking feature of his mummy, shaped outer coffin lid, and the very important, that was the public was most interested in it. It was, that is, the coffin's cover. Lid means cover. Okay, people were the most interested in that. Some visitors read from the guidebooks in the whisper, and some visitors, they were reading, and that means they were in whispering, means in the low sound over there. Others stood silently, but some were standing silently. They were looking, perhaps pondering Tut's untimely death in his late teens. Perhaps some were thinking over, pondering means thinking deeply over the untimely death, because he died in late teens, as I told you, that is at the age of 19. Or wondering with a shiver, it means they were also shivering by thinking with that one, if the Parose curse, because they believed in all that one, because they used to value, that is, King Tut a lot over there, and he belonged to the Parose family. Parose means king's family over there, and if he were, like, since his dead body was disturbed from there by taking it out, so it might curse them. So they were also scared of that. Death or misfortune falling those who disturbed him, because according to them, those who were disturbing to King Tut over there, that is in the coffin even also, that one, because that he was in the form of a mummy there and was really true, and it means then it might curse them upon them. They were also worried for that. Next paragraph. The mummy is in very bad condition because of what Carter did in 1920. said Jai Hawass, Secretary General of the Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities, as he leaned over the body for a long first look. When the dead body was taken out, it means not that it was the dead body, I should say the mummy, it was there in the coffin. When it was taken out, then Jai Hawass, who looked at it, face that is there, it means very much he looked at that one for a long time. Then he was just telling that in 1920, Howard Carter, he had left the mummy in a very bad condition. That is, it means he was an archaeologist and he wanted to know certain facts, and that then what he did over there, he did not, he left the mummy in a very bad condition. Now here, children, Carter, Howard Carter, that is, was a British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered Tut's tomb after the years of futile searching, its content thou hastily ransacked in antiquity. What he was telling, Howard Carter, in 1922, he discovered the Tut's tomb and he took it out, though for years he was searching that one. Futile, futile means, it means he was not getting success in the beginning. Futile means of no use. The search was of no use. It means he did not get it, but ultimately he got it in 1922. Its contents over there, its contents thou hastily ransacked in antiquity. It means whatever, when he found that one, then whatever, because he had three coffins, then all the things were searched very carelessly. Ransacked means very carelessly. That is there, like, but surprisingly complete. Like here, thou hastily ransacked antiquity. Were surprisingly complete, but still okay. He just like maybe he wanted to do some wanted to know certain facts or something, so he disturbed the mummy. That is a lot over there, but still the things were still complete there. It means the things were there. They remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become part of the pharaoh's legend. They remain the richest royal collection. It means the things inside the coffin, as there were in one, there was the mummy, and the another, in the two coffins were there, where the other things were there. A lot of gold was there, the things of daily use were there, like there were so many things were there. So, like here, they remain the richest. It means whatever the things were there, richest royal collection ever found and have become part of the pharaoh's legend. Legend means, that is, it means because they believe in that one. Like it means the successors over there, the stories were there, then in that one it is considered King Tut had the maximum royal collection in their coffins. Stunning artifacts in gold, their eternal brilliance meant to guarantee resurrection, caused a sensation at the time of discovery. Children, now here you pay attention. Each line, it means you must try to understand that one. Like here, stunning artifacts of gold. Stunning means surprisingly, very much bright even also. That is, their eternal brilliance. It means shine was there even after these many thousand years after that mummy was taken out. When the Howard Carter had taken out, then at that time the shine was there like that only. And that was given the guarantee that they believed in resurrection. Resurrection means that there was life after death. And there was a sensation. His discovery was a sensation. Okay. And it drew the attention of many people and still get the most attention. Okay. It drew the attention of many people. But Tut was also buried with everyday things. He would want in the afterlife board games, a bronze razor, linen, undergarments, cases of food and wine. When the Tut's coffins were searched, then they came to know that Tut was also buried with the things of every, because they believe in resurrection. As I told you, resurrection means there was life. They believed in that there is life after death. So if the person's life is there after death, means the person would be needing all those things. So along with him, that these things were kept. So in his coffins also there were board games were there, like how the kings used to play with that one. A bronze razor was there, being that is he might be needing. Linen undergarments were there, cases of food and wine. Now children, after months of careful recording the pharaoh's funerary treasures, Carter began investigating his three nested coffins, opening the first. Like here, after months of careful searching, it means careful recording, It means they kept on finding the things, they kept on recording the things, what was in the coffins and something. Funerary treasure, the word it is given to them, funerary treasure means treasure that was found in the coffins. Carter began investigating his three nested coffins. Nested, full of three coffins were there. Opening the first, what was found in the first coffin? He found a shroud adorned with garlands of willow and olive leaves. That is, there were shroud. Shroud means one cover was there, and that cover was decorated with shroud. That is the cover that is put on the dead body. Okay, a piece of cloth that is put on the dead body. It was decorated, adorned means decorated with garlands of willow and olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and cornflowers. These were that is the things of vegetation, flowers. Because when a person dies, then we put also the flowers there. So from that one, the evidence, it was got out from there, the faded evidence of a burial in March or April. The narrator is telling, it means he died and he was buried in the month of March or April. Because these things, olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals, cornflowers, willow, they are found in the month of March or April. When he finally reached the mummy, though he ran into trouble. The ritual resins had hardened, cementing to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. No amount of legitimate force could move them. Carter wrote later what was to be done. When he finally reached the mummy, it means when he found it out, then what did he there? Then there was one trouble. It means the mummy was one resin. Resin means sticking substance was used there in that one, so that it could remain with the coffin. But it had become very much hard, very much hard. It had become like that one, and the mummy was. It was difficult for a mummy to remove from that coffin. The ritual resin had hardened. It had become hard, cementing truth to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. And it was cementing, it means it was difficult the mummy to take it out, like a cement. It had become very much hard, and the down, it was of solid gold, and it had got stuck to that one. No amount of legitimate force could move them. No legitimate force, legitimate means legal force, could not move them. It was not removed from the bottom of the coffin. Carter wrote later what was to be done. The Carter had written in the investigation that he did not know in the beginning what to do. Then that is, he had to find out certain facts. That is, being an archaeologist, but he was not able to remove that. The sun can beat down the hammer this far south in the Egypt. And Carter tried to use it to loosen the resin. Then it means you can just see in Egypt there is a hot weather, is hot in the summer, and then it is like it is given over there, sun can beat down like a hammer means it too much hot is there. Okay, and then what he did, he left the mummy outside so that let the resin, it means the sticking substance, let it become loose so that they could remove it. For several hours, let me just complete it, for several hours it was left outside so that the resin could loose. Children, I am stopping it here. Explanation is over. Part 1's explanation is over. Like, okay, as I'm telling you again, this chapter is difficult one. Read it again and again, again and again. I have given you meaning of difficult words while telling you only over there so that you will understand it. Okay, children? Okay, bye. Take care. Be